The Dictabelt, a recording medium of the 1950s. The advent of sound recording and reproduction had begun by the end of the 19th century with Edison, who used tin foil as a support for sound. By the 20th century, the first recording media for domestic entertainment were hollow cylinders made of hard wax, which could store about 3 minutes of sound. The fragility of the cylinders required delicate manipulation and a reliable machine for playback. The groove of the cylinders is cut vertically at varying depths, hill and dale. Without any electronic amplification, the cylinder phonograph used only mechanical means and gave a poor reproduction. Launched in 1947, the Dictabelt was a thin, floppy cylinder made of vinyl, red, blue or purple in colour. It was resistant, and provided it was not flattened, it could be safely stored in an envelope. The groove created by the rotation of the Dictabelt and of the lateral movement of the recording stylus on the surface allows recordings from 15 to 30 minutes, depending on the machine used. The first Dictabelt players, which used vacuum tube amplifiers, were rather heavy and had numerous tiny mechanical parts. The Dictabelt is inserted by pushing it around the guides. The machine is then ready for recording. The Dictabelt is then stretched between two rollers and set in motion. The recording stylus can be moved from left to right to the point chosen for recording or listening. Markers were used to access a recording or a blank section. A few years later, with the advent of transistors, smaller and lighter devices appeared. The loading and manipulations were simplified and global performances enhanced. After the positioning of the recording stylus, a remote control was used to start the recording or the reproduction. It featured play, record, and a replay function.
Hello, testing 1, 2, 3 on this little instant recorder here.
Yeah. It also featured the same marker system, but operated electrically. It is possible to play a few Dictabelts correctly using vintage machines, but the reliability is jeopardized as soon as numerous playbacks of sensitive archives are required. A modern device, the Archeophone, made to play cylinders of all types and diameters, including the floppy ones such as the Dictabelts, is a perfectly adapted tool, both flexible and reliable. The manipulation of the machine is extremely easy.
Here we are talking on this little machine. It has remote control. That's one of the reasons it's expensive. You know, it's got remote control facilities where you can play it right from the mic without going to the machine.
The rotation speed can be adapted perfectly to the speed of the Dictabelts, whether 15 or 30 minutes, should they be recorded on machines powered at a frequency of 50 to 60 Hz. The interchangeable styli are chosen so as to obtain the best signal with the minimum surface noise. Playback with a stereo cartridge allows for better restoring options. Loading a Dictabelt on the mandrel is simple and easy. The machine possesses an adjustable diameter mandrel. This allows for an optimized tightness with no risk of tearing the medium. When the medium is flattened, severe clicks spoil the signal at each rotation of the cylinder. A tightness gently added to the jaws of the mandrel on the whole length of the Dictabelt allows a considerable reduction of the clicking problem, and this without any squashing of the Dictabelt and without the need to heat in order to soften or loosen the vinyl. As a result, the Dictabelt is not damaged. On the other hand, the possibility of playing backwards allows, after an electronic reversal of the signal, the restitution of the very first seconds of the groove. The Archeophone is therefore the ideal tool to get the best out of the Dictabelt floppy cylinders.
Dictaphone Time Master, the greatest of all hi-fi's. Hi-fi-fo-fum.